was a divided house. A section of the party demanded collective leadership, but another reposed faith in the Gandhi family. According to sources, interim President Sonia Gandhi offered to quit, asking the Congress Working Committee to initiate the process for selecting a new party chief. The committee has urged Sonia Gandhi to continue as interim party chief and to bring changes to strengthen the organization. The sources said the Congress Working Committee has decided to convene an AICC session at the earliest to start the process of selecting a new party chief.
The CWC unanimously requests Srimati Sonia Gandhi to continue to lead the Indian National Congress until such time as circumstances will permit an AICC session to be convened.
In her opening remarks at the video conference, which was called in the wake of a section of the party leaders seeking a full-time and visible Congress president, Sonia Gandhi made the offer to quit. Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, who spoke after Gandhi, urged her to continue, as did former Defence Minister A.K. Antony. Singh and Antony criticized the letter written by some party leaders.
बात करने की स्वतंत्रता है, पत्र लिखने की आजादी है, लेकिन उसको properly party forum पे discussion होना चाहिए, public domain में नहीं जाना चाहिए.
It was a day of flip-flops from Congress leaders as reports emerged that some senior Congress leaders raised a banner of revolt against the leadership. Gulam Nabi Azad, who leads the opposition benches in the Rajya Sabha, added to these rounds. Was wrongly reporting that in the Congress Working Committee meeting, he told Rahul Gandhi to prove that the letter written by Azad and others was in collusion with the BJP. Azad tweeted, and I quote, "Let me make it very clear that Sri Rahul Gandhi has neither in CWC nor outside said that this letter was written at the behest of BJP. What I said was, yesterday, some Congress person had said that we did it at the behest of BJP, and in that context I said, it is most unfortunate that some colleagues outside CWC have accused us of collusion with the BJP, and if those people can prove this allegation, I will resign." It all began around 1 p.m. when Kapil Sibal tweeted that Rahul Gandhi had said some Congress leaders were colluding with the BJP. In an emotional outburst, Sibal said in the last 30 years, he had never made a statement in favor of the BJP on any issue. Close on the heels of Sibal's tweet came a denial from Congress spokesperson Randeep Surjewala at 1:30 p.m. He said, and I quote, "Sri Rahul Gandhi hasn't said a word of this nature or alluded to it. But yes, we all need to work together in fighting the Modi rule rather than fighting and hurting each other and the Congress." At 1:47 p.m. came Kapil Sibal's U-turn. He tweeted, and again I quote, "Was informed by Rahul Gandhi personally that he never said what was attributed to him. I therefore withdraw my tweet." The ruling BJP reacted predictably. Senior BJP leader and Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan said the Congress's future was in darkness and nobody could save the party. Another BJP leader, Uma Bharti, slammed the Congress leadership. She said there was no credible face left in the opposition party.
Congress mein sach bolne wale ko gaddar kaha jata hai. Jab Sindhia ji ne awaaz uthai to wo bhajpa se mile hue ho gaye, un par aarop laga diye gaye. और आज जब गुलाम नबी आजाद और कपिल सिब्बल जैसे नेताओं ने आवाज उठाई कि पूर्णकालिक अध्यक्ष चाहिए, तो उनको कह दिया कि वो भाजपा से मिले हुए हैं, ऐसी पार्टी को कोई नहीं बचा सकता।
ये कांग्रेस का अंदरूनी मामला है। अब मैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी का सदस्य हूँ,